yesterday the budget came out, and after much fanfare about the government's spending on education, I was really excited because I thought, in addition to the Rutherford Public School upgrade, which is here, and also the Bulwarra Public School upgrade, which is actually a re-announcement of the 2015 funding that was made in the election, that there might be something for Gilliston Heights School, because this is a school that I have explained to the minister needs some help. Now, I tried getting some meetings with the former Minister for Education, Adrian Piccoli, who refused to meet with me about this school. And when Rob Stokes came on the scene, I thought things might improve. So I asked the minister if he would meet with me. He refused to do so far. So I went out to Gilliston and I made a little bit of a video about all of the issues at the school. Now, 3 weeks or so ago, we sent that video to the minister's office, again requesting a meeting, so he hasn't actually given us that date. So what I've done today is I've got my trusty computer and I am putting in this file. I'm gonna go and I'm gonna walk up to the minister's office and I'm going to deposit that with his staff and ask them if I can have a meeting with him as soon as possible in relation to this. So after this, you'll see a copy of what's on this USB, because I think if the minister doesn't want to talk about it, if the minister doesn't want to watch the video, then you as the public have every right to see how bad the education facilities are at one of our local schools. So I'm here at Gilliston Public School, Gilliston Heights, and I've been talking to parents this afternoon about a lot of the issues that the school's having in terms of infrastructure. Now, when you look at the schoolyard, you can see so many demountable buildings, and it looks like there's this fantastic piece of ground for the kids to play, but when you see it's so sloped, and it's actually out of bounds for the kids, as is this area directly behind me. So there's a lot of problems when we put all these demountables into school buildings, and we don't look at the playground availability for the students, and we're not providing them with permanent learning spaces. There's been some concerns expressed about the safety of the road here as well, particularly it's now getting to be quite a built up area. So I'm here with Danielle from Gilliston Heights Public School. She's one of the parents and she's got a son who attends this school. She's been talking to me with a lot of other parents around some issues that they're having with facilities at the school. So can you tell me a bit more about the demountables that are here?
Well, we have, as you can see, the hall is a demountable and it's not an adequate size for the amount of students that we have here.
Yep.
Also, all classrooms apart from two are demountables.
So all classrooms apart from two on this school site
are demountables. Right. Yes. As well as there's only one toilet block that's not a demountable. The other toilet block is demountables.
Right, right. And then with the hall not being sort of big enough for the school, how does that impact on the children and their parents?
Well, when parents come for assemblies, we have to line up, stand on the stairs out the front of the hall, so we don't actually all get to go in there at the one time and visibly see our children at assembly.
Right, so that's pretty harsh, isn't it? Because kids love seeing their mum and dad at the... And in terms of the school site, like, it looks like there's a lot of green grass for the kids to play on, but not much play, because they, you know, it's a pretty big space, is that right?
Technically, they're not allowed to go anywhere past the edge of the hall. So all of what you can see down there, they can't actually use that anyway.
So it's really just this area and then in front of those demountables.
This area here that you see now is out of bounds. It's virtually just from there in woods.
Wow. So they don't have much green space. And what do they do with play equipment and things like that?
We don't have play equipment.
So nothing?
No, we've had no play equipment since the superstorm that happened.
That's really tough. And so is there any plans to replace that?
There's plans for replacement. The PNC have raised money to go towards new equipment.
That's good. So when is that expected to happen, do you know?
Hopefully within the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, and you're president of the PNC?
Yep, just got elected.
Yeah, that's good. Congratulations. And it's good to see you being a spokesperson for the school and you know, to stand up and say you want better facilities. It's something that we're finding across Maitland.
Yep.
So thanks very much for
that's
your time.
Okay. Thank you.
So as you can see, this is the hall here behind us, and there's raised steps you can see at the back of the building in order to get up into the hall. The parents have also told me about how small that is, the hall itself. But just imagine coming to a school like this where everything is pretty much raised, including some of the toilets. That creates all sorts of problems for children with disabilities. The other concern I've got is this is probably one of the only schools that I am aware of in Maitland, or one of the fewest schools in Maitland, which has got such a low school fence. You know, this is the height of the fence here. You know, if you look at most schools these days, they've got those big black school fences. The problem for that is, of course, security and safety for the students. And I'm told by the parents that one of the girls, who is a bit of a runner, gets put in a high-vis vest so that when she does climb over this school fence, they can find her. Now, to me, that's a shocking, shocking situation. If we can't protect our children in their school environments in this day and age, a bit better than that, I really wonder what this government's priorities are in regards to safety of our children. So this is the end of the school zone, which is not very handy for a lot of the parents and students who come out of this back gate at the end of the day. So I was just here at the end of the school day. At 3:05, this area was totally filled with cars. We had kids running across the road to parents in cars on the other side. And it's the end of the school zone. One of the parents came and told me about her car being sideswiped by a truck that had actually been contracted to deliver fruit and vegetables to the school. You know, this is not safe for students in our school. It's not good enough for Gilliston Heights and their community here to be having dangerous situations where the school zone ends before the access gate to the school. So this is the newest demountable at Gilliston Heights Public School. It's the ninth demountable, I'm told by parents. It's been put in the school. I haven't gone around and counted them all because I'm not allowed on that side of the fence. So we arrived this year. Now, when you look at the school and just how it kind of generally looks, it's a bit of a contrast to the houses that the future parents of this school have built on the other side of the road. I raised this issue with the Department of Education Assets Unit, and they told me it was very hard to connect up town sewer to the school, and so that's why they were having the issue and it was having to be on septic still. But I just can't understand why, you know, 20 metres away, these people I'm sure aren't on septic, and yet over here the school community is having to make do. Some of the students who've got sensory deprivation issues and disorders have a lot of trouble going to particular toilets within the school grounds because of the condition and the smell that often accompanies septic systems. In 2017, we have to ask ourselves, is this the standard that we want for schools in our community? So here we are, it's the Minister for Education's office. I've got the little video and I'm going in to give it to his staff and see if we can get that meeting happening.